My name's Evan, and I sing in Alviandro.
My name is Drama, and I play bass in Alviandro.
Actually, I'm from Dallas, Texas, and I've been playing music in the Dallas scene for a long time, years upon years, and I've even had a little success with it. I just wasn't really happy with the way things were progressing, and I personally didn't feel like I really deserved any of the things I got, and I kind of realized the best step was just to start over and write this like lean and start from scratch. And, Sean was one of those people that was just there from the beginning, and to be honest, he didn't even really, he's always been around music, I guess I'm talking for you, but he's always been around music, but never really on the music making side of things, and I was like, dude, you are the right person in this band, and he was honest, like, the only person I ever met, you have to be in this band, and he was like, what are you going to play, and I was like, dude, bass guitar, and he was like, cool, and he jumped on it, and so that fell together. I just love meeting people all over the country and seeing parts of the country. Detroit's beautiful.
Meeting people is awesome. One of the funnest things. I love living in a van. I'm probably one of the few people in the world that loves living in a van. I will sleep in the van. I will sleep in that van. I love everything about it.
We get played, like, sometimes people will be like, yo, you guys can stay with us, no problem. He's like, I'm going to sleep in the van anyway. Yep. Like, he just loves the van.
I love it.
Meeting people can be just fans and other bands. Anybody that's just passionate and making music for the right reasons. I just love seeing musicians that are up there not selling their merchandise, but up there just selling their souls, you know, just their emotions.
I feel better now.
This day and age in music, you can have so many different genres. Honestly, it's not important about who it is, it's about how it is.
Just people that care themselves the right way and love music. Anybody. Smack Sean in the head with a microphone. I swing the microphone and the thing is, we're really good at it, and we're really good. He's really good about watching where I am, and he knows what I'm gonna do, and I'm really good at it too. But for whatever reason, there's just one moment in time where, I guess he thought I was going over it, and I thought he was coming in. It just the microphone was out there, probably like 10 feet away, and it was coming back, and I saw him, and it was too late. And I heard you could hear it. It was bad too. And, he played through it, and I felt so guilty. I was like, crap, I hope he's okay. And then he just, like, ran up in front of the stage and just, like, screamed the lyrics and stuff. So, he's all right.
My most embarrassing moment is one night, I'm playing a show, I don't know where it was, but I jumped off of something and I literally split my hand out, like, ear to ear. And it was just a sad, like, huge hole in my head.
There's been a lot of tour pranks, and they get out of hand pretty quick, and to be honest with you, we're not a band that you want to prank, because we have a dude in our band, named Josh, who plays drums for us, that will take it
too far,
just to where you can't even see the line anymore.
Like, the line's right here, and probably second prank in, he's already in.
Yeah, he just too far, too soon, but I like the little pranks. We had a tour manager in the past who would drive for us a lot, and we have, like, mirrors on our band, side mirrors that could move manually, and every day I would go and I just barely move them. So, like, to the point where he thought it was just, like, you know, like, I think something the band did. But in the tour, he's like, man, this mirror's driving me crazy. I was like, dude, that's me. He was like, like pulled out of my hands and started licking it like right in front of me.
Oh.
It's not like crazy, but we were all just like, I got a brush today. What are you doing?